Hi everyone, Greg Wilkins back here with you with another edition of the Daily Pause, a devotional of positivity and encouragement for Wednesday, April 6th, 2022. As always, I pray that you not only have a very blessed day today, but that today's devotional will help encourage, inspire, motivate you, and put a smile on your face as well. Check us out on my Facebook page, The Daily Pause, or on my YouTube channel, Greg Wilkins, as well as Twitter at GregWilkins78, where you can leave your comments, devotional topic requests, any birthday or anniversary shoutouts for your friends and loved ones. Submit any audio or video performances that you would like to see featured as a part of this devotional, or catch up on any past episodes you might have missed. I pray that this devotional, as well as any episode you may have watched in the past, and prayerfully any episode you may watch in the future, will continue to be a blessing and encouragement to you for your entire day. Let's get started with today's devotional as we continue our countdown to Easter. And the devotional is titled today, Our Best. Christopher McIntyre III was a phenomenal football player, wide receiver, and kickoff returner for his high school team, and had already secured himself a scholarship to Ohio State University. And they were in their state championship game, and they found themselves down at halftime by 27. It's kind of off for this team. They're going undefeated so far this year, and they averaged 53.7 points a game. And the rest of the team just felt that they were out of it. But Christopher kept reminding them, nope, there's two halves to a game. We got this, y'all. We got this, y'all. And his energy was just so vibrant, and it really rallied the troops inside the locker room. They were excited going back out. They received the ball at the beginning of the second half. And like I said, Christopher was a great kickoff returner. So he got that ball on kickoff return and went untouched to the end zone and scored a touchdown. Now they're down by 20. The defense forced an interception, and so they got the ball back. Second play after getting the ball back after the interception, they did a toss sweep to the wide receiver, Christopher, and he went untouched for 55 yards for another touchdown. So now they're down by 13. And the opposing team went and scored a touchdown, so they're down by 20 again, but they quickly came back with another kickoff return and down by 13. And that ended the third quarter. At the beginning of the fourth quarter, they had the ball back, and the quarterback drops back for a pass, and they threw the ball to Christopher. And he goes for a 23-yard gain. He gets pushed out of bounds, but when he gets pushed out of bounds, he lands awkwardly on his leg, and it was a compound fracture. Very ugly. Very, very ugly. Both teams were stunned. The crowd was stunned. The ambulance came and put him on the stretcher and put him back in the ambulance, and the team was distraught. They were just distraught. They're like, oh no, what are we going to do now? And the coach rallied everybody together and said, nope, Christopher brought us back in this game. He gave us new life in this game. We can't let this go now. Let's give it our best. Let's give it our best. Let's give it our best. We're only down by 13. We can do this. We can do this. They went, and long story short, after six overtimes, they lost the game. But the performance was just extremely phenomenal. They gave their best performance. Even in loss, they gave their best performance. We see that a lot in sports. We see it when a particular athlete does their best, and whether it be Michael Jordan's flu game or the catch from David Tyree off the helmet against the Giants game against the Patriots in the Super Bowl, Steph Curry and all the phenomenal games he has, LeBron James, the games he has, Friedman in the World Series last year for Atlanta before he went to the Dodgers, but we won't talk about that. Those athletes and many more have done many, many performances, and some have done performances in which they got injured, just like Christopher did, and it rallied the team. It gave the team a new lease in life. They played like they never played before in that game. That's what it is with our walk with Christ. In our lives, like we know what the Lord has done for us by coming down to from heaven and sacrificing his life for us. His love for us was so great. We were condemned in our sins. We were condemned to death because of our sins. But because he gave his best, because he loved us so much, we have to do our best in everything that we do, say, and think. The Bible reminds us that whatsoever we find at our hands to do, do it with all our might. Because the Lord gave his best for us by cleansing our sins with his blood and dying on the cross for us, taking our place on the cross. We should always continue to do our best. That's how we show, because there's nothing we could ever do to repay what the Lord has done for us. But what can we do? We can give our best to everything we do, because when we give our best, we show that we are representing Him and what He's done for us by giving us new lease of life, giving us new energy in our lives, giving us life more abundantly through what His love for us and His sacrifice for us by laying down His life for us. As Christopher gave new energy to his football team by his passionate speech at halftime and his phenomenal performance, even through his compound fracture, he gave his football team new life. Jesus gave us new life by what He did for us. And because of what He did for us, we should give our best in everything that we do. Which brings us to today's feature song. It's a song off the album Purpose by Design by Fred Hammond and Radical for Christ. And the name of the song is When You Praise. And it's a worship song that states, when you praise, there should be a fire in your heart. We shouldn't give 55% of a praise, just like we shouldn't give 55% of our job or our schoolwork. If we give less than 100%, we're not going to get anything back from it. But because we've got the Lord giving us such a new lease on life, we should give a 150 trillion percent effort in our praise. And whatever we do, however we do it, we should give it our all. Like the song says, there should be a fire, a burning desire in our heart. Because there's a song that says, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all He's done for me, my soul cries out, hallelujah, the highest praise. And it continues to say, thank you, Lord, for saving me. And I'll add to that, for redeeming my soul, for blessing my soul, for increasing me, for healing me, for providing for me, for protecting me. And it goes on and on and on and on and on. And that's the type of praise we should give when we know what the Lord has done for us. By dying on the cross on Calvary, for raising up from the dead with all power in His hand. And because He got up, we can get up. And because we got up, we can give our best to all that we can do, including our praise to Him. So whatever we find our hands to do, whether it be mopping floors, whether it be digging ditches, whether it be doing schoolwork, whether it be working in a factory, whether it be making up a bed, whatever we find our hands to do, whatever it is, even if it's praise and worship, especially praise and worship, we should give our best for what He has done for us, because He's simply given us His best because He loved us that much. Let's pray. Father God, we thank You for who You are and what You are to us. We thank You that You gave Your best for us, that we may have a new lease in life. Your word says, he that is in Christ is a new creature. Old things are passed away. Behold, all things have become new. Because of Your blood, because of Your dying on the cross for us, we have a new lease on life. And we thank You for an opportunity to be joint heirs of Your kingdom with You, because You loved us that much. We thank You and we praise You in all that we do. We give You our best. We should never give You less than our best in all that we do. In Jesus' name, amen. Before we go, we want to give our birthday and anniversary shout outs. No anniversary shout outs for today, but we do have some birthday shout outs to share with you. Happy birthday to Asa Fullerminder. Happy birthday to Luther Bradley. Happy birthday to my dear cousin, Patrick Sitton, and happy birthday to Heather Kitchen. Heather, Patrick, Luther, and Asa, I hope you all have a very blessed birthday. May God bless you with many more, and enjoy your birthday on today. Before we go, we also have a random trivia fact to share with you. The largest animal in the entire animal kingdom, whether it be land, sea, or air, is the blue whale. At about 82 feet, it can weigh up to 200 tons. It is by far the largest animal in the animal kingdom. So large, in fact, that the tongue of the blue whale weighs as much as the African elephant, which is about 15,000 pounds. Hope you enjoyed that random fact. And if you have any random trivia facts that you would like to share with me, to share with the daily on the Daily Pause, you can send it to me or leave me a comment below where you're watching, or send me a tweet at GregWilkins78, an email at GLWilkins78. At outlook.com. You can Facebook message me, or you can tweet me. You can text me at 864-706-5916. One more thing before we go. We are in full stride in our Daily Pause Inspirational Music Tournament, and we are entering the second round of the choir bracket. The upper half second round has already started. The voting for the number one seed, Hezekiah Walker and the Love Fellowship Crusade Choir, going against the nine seed, John P. Key and the New Life Community Choir in match 9, and in match 10, a number 4 seed, the Howard Gospel Choir, going against the number 5 seed, the University of Utah Singers, in match 10. That voting is going on, and that voting ends tonight at 10:30 p.m. So get your votes in by leaving them in the comment section below, or by email, or by Twitter, or you can text me as I adjust my earbud, excuse me. And I will reveal later on today the results of the lower half bracket, matches 5, 6, 7, and 8. And I will give you matches 11 and 12 as well later on today for the lower half of the choir bracket. I hope you're having fun with this tournament. It's really, really fun for me, and I hope it's been a blessing to you. That'll do it for today's edition of the Daily Pause. Enjoy today's feature song, When You Praise, by Fred Hammond and Radical for Christ, from the album Purpose by Design, released in 2000. By Zomba Recordings LLC and provided to YouTube by Verity Records. I found this song off the YouTube channel Fred Hammond Top It. So for more four great songs by Fred Hammond and Radical for Christ, check out his YouTube channel. Continue to love each other, continue to be safe, and remember, every day is always time to take a pause. And Lord willing, I will see you again on tomorrow. Today's feature song starts right now. Take care of yourself. May God be with you on today. And God bless.
Glory to your name. Glory to your name. Together and here tonight if you want to.